You are now watching a Lucky Penny Shop product feature. Hey, it's Lucky Penny Shop, and it's time for me to do my first decorated Easter egg. This is the Candy Apple Easter Egg Set from RJ Rabbit Approved. And, of course, candy apples are bright and shiny and glossy looking, so that's what I hope to achieve here when I get to this here. It says, with that candy apple shine. And of course, he's saying, wow. Let's turn it around here. So the kit includes four candy apple colors. 1, 2, 3, 4. One brush. Ooh, why do they show two? Egg decorating tray. 6 candy apple egg stands and a built-in drying tray. That's what this says. You see the little perforated circles there. It says it's easy to apply a perfect candy apple coating in just seconds. So we're going to check that out. Going to build the stands. I have regular eggs here off to the left and these 12 plastic decorating eggs that I've used actually last year. So I'm going to do some of each so we can see how they each color. So when I come back, I'll have everything out of the box and we'll check it out. All right, I am all set. Everything's out of the box and there was 2 brushes in there. So the picture was correct. Now, I can get these prepped here. What I'll do is I'll get some things prepped, but these are the egg holders. So I'll just rip them here on the perforations. This is easy to do. And they make it look like it's, you know, shiny with the way it's printed. And then these just match up here, and you match that up there, and should just go right in. We'll see. Sometimes it's just a matter of lining it up just right. And yeah, I'm struggling. Well, there you go. Not as easy as I thought. No, just kidding. Just takes a second to situate them. There we go. There's one. There's two. Slide it down. Okay, good. I guess I won't struggle on all of them. I'll come back and I'll do one more now and then I'll save the rest. Because I only think I'm going to do a few of each egg here. Yeah, oh, that was easy. See, that one was easier. All right, I'll do another one. This time I just kind of wiggled it. Could put a little piece of tape on there, too. That would help hold it better. And I'm just going to finish them. Two more. And I think I'm going to prep my box. So I'm all set. This is kind of like my preparation time. Okay. Now if you notice on the box too, they show a different tray. We got a tray with little triangles in it, and this is square. But I'm all set here to just pop out 6 of these, so I'm ready. And then usually I retape it up. I got some tape handy. Just to give it the support you need to. It's kind of like a drying tray, I guess you would call it. And one more. And I'll just take this, fold this back, and tape it down. This way it has that edge support. Otherwise, if you don't, you don't have the support. Okay, so that's set. Okay, and that's my instructions. I'll just leave that like that so I can read my instructions. Here is the dye. We have green, orange, blue, and pink. I was thinking I would get my primaries in there so I can mix and do a rainbow color, but I have no yellow. All right, well, I can mix some things up and we'll go for it. So when I come back, well, you know what? Let me get my eggs ready. So I'm going to open up this pack. And here we go. I guess I can get started right in it. That'll take 3 of these. Ooh. And these are plastic, see? And compared to a real egg, you know, you kind of have to take a second look. So I'll put the real eggs here. And then I'll put my plastic ones here. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Now, what does it say? It said, mix contents of color packets by kneading. Okay. Boy, you color packets are very neat. 4 to 5 times. Got it. Pour each individual packet into its own well. Well. Okay. Let's see if these come apart easy. There's one. There's two. There's three. I am going to have to stop at some point and get some water because I want to clean off my brush and a towel. So let me just get the pink ready here. There's a little tear area there. And it rips real easy, so be careful. I don't think I like that. I think it'd be a little thicker than that, but maybe not. Okay. Put that somewhere where it doesn't stain my top. Now the orange. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut the top instead of trying to rip it. Okay, here's my orange. I'm going to put it far away from that one. It has a strong smell to it. And then the blue. Okay, and one more. And it's on my fingers. And the green, the last one. Okay, so I need to get a cup of water, a little towel, now that I'm all prepped and ready. So there we go. I will be right back. All my supplies are ready now. So I have my little cup of water. And yes, this stuff stays on your hands and fingers. So be prepared to be colored or wear gloves. So I need to just get started here. So it says, hold it firmly, okay, like this. And then paint without overlapping horizontally around the egg. So let's just try one color right now and see what that does. Okay. Without overlapping. Oh man, that's going to be a challenge. That sure doesn't seem easy. Does that seem easy to you? Okay, horizontally. I think I'm just going to hold it this way and try to do a nice line while spinning my candy egg. And this is a plastic egg, so I'm just seeing how this one paints. I really don't want to do a solid blue, so I want to clean up my second line. It's hard to really hold and spin evenly. Candy apple eggs. We did a bunch of eggs last year with different sets, so this year I think we got 4 different sets. All right, rinse, repeat. Let's try this color. A true candy apple red. Ooh, I'm getting some overlap. Yeah, I think, you know, it's gonna look good anyway. And then when you're set, then you just lay it on these little tong areas here. It's like the little pins. Okay, a little thicker red. That's turned into a cool purple, though. Are we going to get the candy apple look? That's what I want to know. Okay, there's color 2. Rinse and repeat. I'll leave this here because it's kind of cool seeing the colors change. And I think I'm going to have to change my grip after this. I mean, you really have to let the thing dry if you don't want colors to overlap at this point. So if you don't want overlapping colors, then gonna have to let it sit between each layer. I really wish I had yellow. Just go round and around. The next egg, I'll do a real egg, and I'll see how this, we'll compare the two, the plastics to the real ones. Okay, not overlapping, impossible. Okay, now watch the color here, watch. Cool. All right, so the last color I haven't tried is the green. Ooh, look at that, it's like a mint green. You ever had an egg just pop out of your hand and fly across the table doing this? Yes, it's not easy. I can honestly say it's not easy. Okay, there, so far, it's looking kind of candelapply, not sure that's a word, candelapply. Okay, so now I think I want to make a new color. So let's take this one here, this green, and a little bit of this pinkish bluish, gives me like a nice brown. Ooh, a nice brown. There you go, a brown egg. It's hard to spin now. So after this, I'm going to lay it down in my little tray and then paint the top. Okay. That's a nice spot. Temporary, so I can paint the bottom. Here, let me get Dudley in here. He can get his Dudley ears dirty. Dudley's from last year. I found him in a box going, oh yeah, we'll use him again. Okay. Ooh, all right. Let's spin this now and see what it takes to paint the top. What color would you do? I don't know. I think I want to do the pink. Let's see if Dudley might make this whole thing easier with these plastic eggs, because it's easy to hold with that. Okay, then it says let it sit, I believe, for 3 minutes. All right, I think that looks pretty cool. Let me do this. I'll take a break between each egg, just so I can clean up here and take a little break. I'll be right back. All right, it is time to start a real egg, and we'll see if this colors differently. Remember, no egg from your refrigerator. They want warm eggs. And then they also said that after it sits here for 3 minutes, then you can pick it up and paint the ends. But since I have Dudley, who's doing a great job, I don't have to do that. So let's decide. How about I do half and half? Half of this orange going this way. I don't want to go this way. I can hold it like this. It's really hard to do long, even strokes on an egg. Well, hard for me anyway. Maybe it's easy for you. It almost seems like it paints better on the plastic ones, doesn't it? Okay, this is leaving like splotches. All right, there we go. I'm gonna let that one dry. Then I'll come back and paint the other half. Okay, so I'll leave that on my little tongs. Don't bump the other egg.
And then let me grab another plastic one. I like how the color, the water starts changing colors.
All right, how about I just go a little crazy here? I just make little sections and colors. No rhyme or reason. Egg splotches, I'll call it. The splotchy egg. Oh, that looks cool. There we go. And I'll come back and color more on that. Ooh, I'm running out of space, so I'll put this one in here. And then, so I gotta let these dry a little bit before I do more to them.
Let me grab another regular egg.
And what do I want to do? Let's try to mix the color again here. Let's take this blue. And the, let's see, the orange? Blue and orange, yeah. Oh, I made a new green, a darker green. Let's mix in a third color and really twist this up. Put the pink in there. Ooh, it's like a really dark, rich burgundy. All right, how about this? I'm just gonna go kind of nutty. Dudley's gonna come in handy here. Although Dudley doesn't work as well with the egg, with the real egg, because they're so heavy, you gotta really grab it. Look at that. Ooh, I kind of like that. All right. I might come back and add more to it on top of that. I'm just going to do the ends because, you know, my hands have it on there already. It's not a big deal. This whole Easter series, you'll see my fingers are going to be colored. Okay, look at that. All right, I'm going to let some things dry, and then I'll come back in 3 minutes, they said, and we'll check them out. Well, I am back. I've given them about 3 minutes to sit, and doesn't that look wet? And it's not wet. It is dry. So what you see now is on a real egg, it's shinier than on the plastic egg. It doesn't look as shiny. Here's a real egg. Looks kind of shiny and wet. And then here is the plastic egg. Ooh, I didn't flip that one. And as you can see, well, that's a little wet there. It really hasn't, doesn't give you that shiny look to it. So I'm gonna set that one up this way. There's a lot of blue on there. And now I can just grab it, see? And finish another color. So while I'm here, I've got orange on this side. It's a little sticky, but for the most part, it's good. We'll do orange and pink. Those are two interesting colors that don't go well together. Don't know why I chose that. Look at that. So now we know the plastic eggs definitely do not work as well as real eggs with this. Anxious to see if anybody else has tried this set. Let me know in the comments. I think I'm just going to stick to these four. I'm not going to do any more. Because my decorating skills need a lot of work. Okay, so let's let that sit. Alright, so that one's done. I was going to try to put some more colors on this one just to mix it up a little bit. Here's a real egg. Let's get some blue in there. Okay, that blue is really darker, so I'm going to move it around a little bit. cool. There. I'm liking that. And then some of this in spots. And this in spots. Now I'm just kind of mixing up all the colors. Kind of give it that cool looking, strange looking egg. Look at that. Right there. Okay, now that's, look at that thing. It sure looks shiny. Okay, one more here. This one still has some blue that hasn't dried yet. So let me just see if I can fill in the areas that have dried. I'm not trying to be super neat here because, you know, I don't want to be. Ooh, my fingerprint, look. There we go. Ooh, run. Look at that. Oh. I sure have a unique looking egg. So definitely not as candle apple-y. I said it again. But still cool. All right, here we go. I kind of like that one. That might be my favorite so far. Okay, there we go. Final coats on all of them. We'll let that dry there. And then 3 more minutes and we'll come back and check them all out and we'll see which one we like the best. Be right back. Well, there you go. There are my 5 eggs. 5? Yes. See this one here? I thought after I had finished those that maybe I should have made one more like the box to paint one all one color. So that is a blue one. As you can tell, which ones are the real eggs? Real egg, real egg, real egg. And it seems like this one for sure isn't too shiny. This has some shininess to it, but not as much as the eggs next to it. So which egg do you like the most? I'm leaning towards, well, I don't know, I really like this speckled one, how it came out. Now, not every side is beautiful, but I think I presented them to the front. Still a little wet there, look at that. So there must have been a spot on there. And by the way, I was able to wash it off my hand, so that's not a problem either. And then here was the orange and pink one. Maybe they're still a little wet where I had them sitting down, but you can hold them. Look how shiny they are. Ooh. Shiny egg. And then this is the one that I just did all sorts of colors on. Look at that. So what do you think for our first egg kit this year? And what I'll do is I'll keep them all till the last kit and then bring them all back in and look at them one more time. So that is the candy apple. I think I kept saying candily apple-y, but you know what I'm saying. It's the candy apple Easter eggs kit. And thanks for watching. If you want to see more Easter stuff, look at that description. We'll have a playlist there. Or as always, you can search Lucky Penny Shop. Later. If you're looking for the item you just saw in the video, click here. Watch more videos by clicking here. Don't forget to share on social media and give a thumbs up.
Hey, LPS Dave.
What's up, Butch?
Make sure they don't forget to subscribe.
Oh, yeah. Please click here to subscribe to Lucky Penny Shop. And always remember when you see a lucky penny,
pick it up.
Thanks for watching.